And we are back, man. Another Jason Bourne experience. New York City's own 200 block. You know what it is, man. Shout out to the Antidote. Shout out Mole Magwood. You know what I mean? We are here. And I got Fly Family in the building.
We in the building, man. Salute to JB the plug, man. You appreciate to be here.
That's a fact. That's a fact, man. So the Fly Family, talk to us about what that consists of.
So when I say Fly Family, like I say, it's more like a movement. I'm all inclusive when I talk about the Fly Family. I'm talking about anybody who, you know, has been persevering and worked through to get through whatever transgressions they're going through. So, you know me, I'm a father of four. I'm a family man. So that's something I take very seriously. So when I say Fly Family, I talk about everybody who, you know, you might have different things on your plate, but regardless, you step up to the plate. Like, you know what I'm saying? So from a movement standpoint, from a mission standpoint, that's what I'm talking about. But on the business end, like I said, I'm talking about El Biz, I'm talking about Mercy, I'm talking about Billy, I'm talking about Frenchie, the people who, you know, are with me every day through this struggle and really trying to, you know, bring this vision to life.
I respect that energy, man. That's how I was really rocking with you brothers, right? Keeping it better, hip hop. You know, we all keeping it humble.
That's a fact. That's a fact. Humble way is the best way.
Being creative out here. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
So, talk to us about, you know, how you take on wearing this many hats, man, and really applying 110% to each one. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people kind of fall off. You may see them coming as an artist, want to dabble in a little bit of executive activities, but not really understand how to execute. So, how have you been able to get over that hump?
I'm going to be honest with you. Being on my own for a very long amount of time. I was living out in Niagara Falls in the Buffalo area for like 15 years. So I had to really figure out every day how to make it on a day-to-day basis by myself. So I discovered like a drive that I didn't have when I could fall back and run back to the crib or had somebody to depend on, like when you was, you know, a youngin' growing up. So as I, you know, turned into a man and went through my, you know, my path that I went through, I really felt like, you know, no matter what, what's on the plate, I can step up and handle it, you know what I'm saying? So I took that drive and then tried to apply it to music. Like, all right, well, I can get these bills paid. Well, let's see if I get this music to happen. All right, well, this is my vision. Let me see if I can, you know, stay focused and not let anything, you know, interfere with that vision and still try to push what my vision is. And I found my success through that.
I dig that. Talk to us. One thing I wanted to always ask you is, how do you really find the inspiration or rather the actual, you know what I'm saying, focus to keep it hip-hop, you know, considering what people may, you know, attribute to be mainstream music or what's kind of trendy.
No, that's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? How do you like stay down to what you really believe in creatively?
In all honesty, transparent, like, I don't listen to a lot, you know what I'm saying? Like, I listen to the couple people who, like, I feel like are in the lane that I'm in, you know what I'm saying? Because I feel like with business, you should pay attention to best practices. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, no biting at all, but like, you definitely want to pay attention to what's, you know, who's winning and what's not winning it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's resonating with the people. You always pay attention to what's going on with the market. So I pay attention to that side, but from a fan standpoint, I still listen to like Golden Era hip hop. I'm still listening to DMX. I'm still listening to Cam. I'm still listening to Hove. I'm still listening to Nas. I'm still listening to Mobb Deep. Like, my playlist is not like a lot of what's out today. I don't really know what's out today.
Oh, man, you can't tell like, you what's going on today, though.
Not, I mean, like, not 100%. But to some extent, from an artist standpoint, because I feel like it's a pool of water. This is my metaphor. It's a pool of water.
Okay.
If you just dip into the pool, the pool's now different. And I want to give them the pool in its purest form. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if I just put a finger in it, the pool's now different. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's gonna, even if you don't want to bite, subconsciously, it's gonna affect you. You know what I'm saying? Like, so it's not like, you know, like, for example, if something comes across my timeline, for example, like the Meek situation.
You're at least to tap in.
Yeah, because I see it. It's not like I'm anti-anything.
Okay.
I listen to what I see. If it flows by me, it flows by me. That means it made it into my attention span. Gotcha. You know what I'm saying? But am I outside every day just look, yo, what's the new shit? Nah, that's not really me. You know what I'm saying?
Like, what are most of your days like, man, as a Fly Family member?
Man, as a Fly Family member, for the most part, I'm working 16 hours a day. Then I'm 4 hours in the studio, 2 hours of sleep, and do it all again the next day. Like, okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what it is.
I respect
like,
that. Yeah, I respect that. Talk to us about the executive brand, man. How did that come together for you? And what was it about the executive brand that made you say, you know what, I could be down with this?
So the thing about the executive brand that was so dope when it comes to Fly Family is they was one of the first, like, conglomerates to actually look at us and see the value that we brought to the table. You know what I'm saying? And I was like Dolo. Like I told you, a lot of the things I learned was being Dolo through the struggle. So shout out to Santana. Big hats off to the bro Santana, because thanks to Billy, because he had a relationship with Santana. They actually came together and brought my product into the discussion. It was like Santana ended up believing in Billy's vision.
You know what I'm saying? Connected.
So, and then I ended up having a brother, you know, for life through that. So,
yeah, that's
you know what I mean? So, salute to the executive brand, because we wouldn't even be here today, you know what I'm saying, with JB. So, shout out to Santana, shout out to Billy, man. So,
definitely.
Because they made them dots happen for the Fly family.
You dropped a project recently, 9/11.
Yep.
I dropped. Talk to us about that.
The Forgotten Ones. So this is actually the first project I ever put out that's not 100% produced by Frenchie. This is produced by a producer named Rob De Niro from Phoenix, Arizona. Shout out to Black Hand Entertainment, Black Hand Music Group. And you know, Rob De Niro was one of the first producers after I dropped the Survivors at the top of the year, who reached out to me like, yo, Jack, I believe in what you're doing, and you know, I think we could really make some history together. So, because he was like, you know, first, like, on some like authenticity shit before anybody was really in my DM or hitting me and, you know, gave a fuck about what I was doing, Robert De Niro was, like, you know what I'm saying? So, if it was going to be Frenchie, it was going to be the, you know, the next person, you know, who really reached out and showed love. So, I spoke to Frenchie about it. He was cool with it, like, you know what I'm saying? So, it was a good brand alignment thing for us.
There you go, man. So, what's the feedback for that, man? Did you catch any kind of flag for being on 9/11?
Nah, like, yeah, nah, well, you know, my story, I'm a 9/11 survivor. I was actually, you know what I'm saying, at 100 Trinity Place when, you know, when the towers fell. So, not for, you know, for any story, but just my real life, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So, the 9/11 thing is actually a reflection of my real life. And if you know my story, the name of my projects, The Survivors, Nothing Was Given, The Sixth Man, The Forgotten Ones, it's a reason for each title. It's a reason for each purpose, each storyline, everything, you know, intertwined. So, I didn't catch any flack. If anything, I got a lot of positive feedback.
I respect you taking that, you know what I mean, that kind of tragedy and kind of like momentous occasion and just turning into some art.
Yeah, it was something I lived through. So, I'm just more reflected on my life, you know what I'm saying? I'm not looking at it as a crazy, you know, tragedy, even though that's what it was. I'm looking at it, that was a day that I had to live through. So when I drop on 9/11, it's because it's a reflection of my life. It's not because of, you know what I'm saying, like all about the towers. It's really about giving you the art in its purest form. Like, you know what I mean? That's like a day that Jag had to live through. Even as we said today, I'm sitting there with somebody who was there with me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like at 100 Trinity Place when the towers fell. So like he was a block away. Like, you know what I mean? It's a different kind of vibe. So the 9/11 date for me, it hits home for the brand. You know what I mean? Like,
yes, sir.
Because I was there. So that's what it's about. It's about the authenticity, about the what's really in the music, the life that's in the music. You know what I mean?
Got you, man. What can we expect for the rest of the fourth quarter from G4JAG and the Fly family?
From G4JAG, you're going to get to see me on my business end for the first time. So shout out to L Biz. I'm putting out Erie County October 3rd. I'm executive producing my first project ever.
Mm-hmm.
I just gave you the Forgotten Ones 9/11. So vinyl CDs available right now. They've been selling like crazy. I've been touching so many countries. So I wanted to touch home too. So, you know, if you're in the vibes, you're in the city, man, please tap me and get into that, because we giving y'all that real hip hop, that pain, man. So
that's
what you went to, get with it. You know what I mean?
My God, G4JAG. Man, tell me where to find you at, man. Social media and all that, man.
Please look for me at g4jag.bandcamp.com or www.g4jag.com. You can find me on all social media, same place, G. Number 4, JAG. Shout out to JB the Plug. Shout out to Moet Santana. Shout out to the executive brand,
that's
man.
Right.
Salute 200 Block, Fly Family. We out here.
You know what it is, man. Jason Bourne, another Jason Bourne experience, man. The antidote, Mole Magwa, of course, Lavasite Magazine. That's how we doing it.